Yo, what's going on, guys? Boy Ethan, hope you're having a great day. We're in the car. You know what that means? We are stuck in traffic. It's a nice Friday day. It's gonna be Friday night, Friday afternoon. What in the world? Oh, let me go. I'm stuck in the middle of the road. You got a van that cut me off. You got a couple cars cutting me off. Whatever. Vlogging while driving. Whatever. Yeah, we're stuck in traffic. We're so close to Encore right now. It's literally right there. I can see it. But stuck in traffic. So it's Friday and we're on the 2-5 list. We're gonna see how it goes. My mindset has shifted from like, we gotta strictly play 2-5 to let's just go with the flow. So I'm on the list. It's always gonna be an option for me, but I'm gonna check out the game, see how I feel, if I'm comfortable with playing it. It's just the fact that it's definitely above my bankroll pay grade, and the higher variance is just, you know, one, it makes it more serious, and also just a little bit more pressure to obviously perform well and play well and all that stuff. So we're gonna see. It's a Friday. There's gonna be action all around, obviously with the high hand promos this month. Well, on top of it being a Friday, it'll be a good time. So we're gonna play for a little bit, see how things go. I think I'm in the right headspace to play well again. I've come to the realization that like, me playing is almost all like dependent on my mood. I play better when I'm in a good mood, when I'm in a, not even when I'm in a good mood, but more so just like a clear, still, and neutral mood. Whereas if I have any emotions, then that leads to me playing pretty bad one way or another. So that's why you can see the fluctuation of vlogs and my play style changes a little bit. So I'm feeling okay today, got a clear mind. Let's go ahead and hop into the games. Depends, we're gonna play 1-3, 2-5. Let's just check out the tables and see it, because we're coming up right now. Let's go ahead and run it up. Let's do it. First hand we're gonna go over today, we have pocket queens in the cutoff with an under the gun straddle. So always love picking up premium hands when there's a straddle on board. I open things up to $25 and two of the most active players on the table make the call. It's the button and the under the gun straddler. So let's go to a flop with the two players that I kind of want to get involved with. Flop comes jack 10-9, two diamonds and a heart out there. So here, overpair, open-ended, action checks to me. So I'm just gonna c-bet here, $55. It's a semi bluff value hand. Like, it's not like I love this, but have an overpair that's super connected. So we're still gonna bet. They both fold and we take down a nice small pot early on in the beginning of the session. Next hand, pocket aces in the small blind, another pretty good premium hand. The button open limps, and here out of position, small blind, not the spot I want to be in, but we're going to play aces. We raise things up to $15, and both players left to act make the call, the button and the big blind. So let's go three ways with as much action as we could have asked for. The flop comes ace, jack, five, two spades out there. Out of position, flop top set, and the high hand is in effect right now, so it's going to judge my decision making just a little bit. Here with the base, with the nuts right now, and I can improve to aces full of whatever, and I have the opportunity to win $1,000 at the end of this 20 minutes, so it's actually very important that we can improve here. So here I'm actually going to check play this for the high hand, because I don't think I'm going to make that much money anyways. So I check, and the player to my left, the big blind, makes a bet of $15. The button folds, and here I'm gonna flat. I'm trying to see a turn river. Let's try to improve. Also, I didn't actually notice that there were two spades out there and there's a flush draw. That's my fault, but we're trying to improve to a full house. That would be awesome, and it would qualify our hand. The turn is the 10 of spades, so the spade draw gets there, unfortunately. But we do have the redraw to the nuts, to basically the all of the nuts. So here I'm just going to check once again. I want to see a river because we want to improve to a high hand. Like I said, he goes out and throws out a bet of $45, and now the high hand just hit on some other random table, quad eights. So unlikely that we're going to improve to a high hand here. Let's actually play our hand straightforward now and go for value here with top sets and the redraw to the nut flush. We go ahead and raise to $150. He has effectively like 200 behind after the $45 bet. I go ahead and raise things up, put in the check raise. Let's go for value and get some money in, because we're not going to hit the high end anymore. And he doesn't think for too long before making the fold here. that was interesting. I didn't expect him to fold here. I guess results wise, I could have raised for a smaller amount perhaps, but here we just don't really get any more money, but totally fine. We squeezed out a little bit of value if he was bluffing here somehow. So we've been winning hands, crazy. I've never started a 1-3 session up before. And here in this hand, we have king, queen offsuit in early position. I open things up to $15. We get the button and a small blind player to make the call. So we're going to go to a flop, which is pretty good for us. It's queen high. It's queen, eight, deuce, two hearts out there. So here, flopping top pair, pretty good kicker. I go ahead and c-bet $25. We get a caller from the button. He has been shown to play a lot of hands, pretty active, and definitely pretty good action here. So we're going to go to a turn, hoping to get some more value. The turn is the king of spades. Now we turn top two. Let's try to get some more value. I bet $65. He is very active, like I said, and raises things up to $200 with about $107 behind. Action onto me. And we're just going to go for, I'm not really sure what he could be raising with. He doesn't really raise too much, so it seems like it's for value. But with top two, way too strong to fold and go anywhere. I go ahead and just rip it all in, 307 effective, and he makes the call. We go to a river, which is the ace of clubs. We expect top two or not, well, two pair to be good here. We show, and he shows us the bad news. Pocket queens. Ah, didn't see that one coming. Pocket queens. He just flatted my raise pre and flatted my bet on the flop, and pretty great card for him to get all my chips. So after that cooler of a situation, we go ahead and add on another $300, and let's go ahead and get into more hands. This next spot, we have king jack off suit in the small blind. There's four limpers to me, and just feeling a little tilted, we go ahead and make a very loose raise here in the small blind to $20. Understanding that's an active table, we get three callers, so we're gonna go four ways to a flop, which comes queen 10-4, two clubs out there. Here, this whole hand was played horrendously, all right? This hand was played very bad. The lines I've been taking is bad. Anyways, I go ahead and lead out for $55 open-ended multied way because I am a huge fish. And it folds to a middle position player, the player, same player who had pocket queens and stacked me. He goes ahead and raises things up to $110, min raises. It folds all the way back to me, and here, like, obviously we saw him raise for value. Min raise, definitely for value here. He could have a lot of top pair hands, and, you know, yeah. So here, I'm just not going to go anywhere yet. It's too small of a raise, and we go to a turn, so we just call. Turn is pretty good for us. It is the ace of diamonds, and yeah, it was the perfect gin card. We didn't want to see a club, and we got there with the nuts Broadway right now, and obviously, I go ahead and check. Oh, God, what am I thinking? I literally thought for a while, and I was like, oh, you know, he raised. Maybe I could just check raise jam this spot. No, you idiot player. You've been playing for too long to know not to check when you should bet for value all the time. Terrible. I check, and here are my notes. It says, I have to bleeping bet this in all caps. If you want to see it, right, I'm going to show you here. I hope you can see that I have to... I hope you can see this. How freaking bad. Where is it? Here. I have to effing bet here. Yeah. Pretty bad. Regardless, that. Oh, I hope that eliminated all the comments below. I check, and he checks it back because he should check this back. We go to a river, which is the deuce of clubs. Of course, the clubs get there, so it's not even like I'm going to get that much value. I'm not really putting them on the clubs, but it's hard to get value from a one pair hand when clubs gets there and an overcard gets there and he checked the turn. So that's unfortunate. I am going to have to bet now to make up for the loss of value on the turn. I bet $75. He calls fairly quickly. We show and we're obviously good. He had queen 10 for top two pair and we lose pretty much a lot of value. We probably could have doubled up there in that hand, but yeah, we are a fish. After that disaster of a hand, we have 5-6 of clubs under the gun. It's a six-way limped pot. I go ahead and limped my suited connectors because one, you know, shouldn't really be raising this hand out of position, especially under the gun. And I still wanted to play it for, you know, some high hand bonuses. So we go to a flop six ways limped pot. It's ace 6-6 rainbow. So we flop trips. We cannot improve to a high hand because our five kicker is no good with the ace out there. So I just check here in this spot. I really should have let out sometimes, but I checked and the player to my left makes a bet for me, which is pretty nice. He bets $15 and it folds all the way back to me. And I decide to make the call. It's pretty obvious. He probably has an ace. Not likely. He has the case six. So, we go to a turn heads up. I'm out of position. Turn is the three of clubs. Bring in a full rainbow and here put him on that ace. I know he has to call a lot of the time, so I go ahead and throw out a bet of $25. He doesn't think too long before making the call. So like I said, putting him on an ace. The river is the case six, so we do make quads, which is really nice. So obviously, I think we're good here most of the time. Not a lot of the time or all of the time, just most of the time. Anyways, here I am going to bet pretty big, pretty much forcing any ace to call. Any ace is pretty much forced to call in this spot, so I go ahead for some value. I bet $80. He doesn't think too long before throwing in the call. We show our hand and we're good. And I think he had ace 10 or something like that. So we do get hit quads in this month, which is nice. Unfortunately, I just did not qualify for the high hand. Two hands later, we pick up ace 8 of hearts in the small blind. And the middle position player raises things up to $15. And there are four total callers, including myself. So, yeah, not getting away from this one in the small blind. So we go ahead to a flop five ways. Flop comes ace 10 7 rainbow top pair, and I do have a lot of backdoor equity, I guess. So I just check, and the pre-flop raiser middle position bets $30. The cutoff makes the call, and here out of position, I'm just gonna peel one as well. I don't feel confident with my ace, my top pair shitty kicker, but we have a lot of backdoor equity. So we call as well, and we're going three ways to a turn, which is the six of hearts. Beautiful card for us as it really vastly improves our hand and all of the backdoor draws could possibly get there. So here I actually go ahead and lead out in this spot with all of my equity. I go ahead and throw out a bet of $90. The preflop raiser folds and the cutoff tanks for about three whole minutes or pretty long time. So putting him on some sort of one pair hand, obviously not two pair at all. He could easily have a bigger ace than us, but we just have so many outs and so many cards, good cards for us on the river here. So we're just going to put him in a tough spot. After tanking for a long time, he decides to make the call. So we go to a river, which is the nine of spades, and awesome card for us as we break out on the flush draw, but obviously we improve to a straight. He has about 125 behind, so here, first to act, we effectively put them all in, $125 bet essentially, and he tanks once again for a long time. Really want him to call, obviously, since we're good a lot of the time. And he eventually does decide on making the call. We show and we are good. He later told me that he had a hand or a kicker better than mine on the turn, which made a lot of sense, but didn't fold on the river. So we get some more value and we're moving on. Next hand, pocket sixes in middle position. There are three limpers to the player to my left. Yes, I limped with sixes, and he raises things up to $12, and all three of us limpers decide to make the call. So we're going to go to a flop four ways. Flop comes queen 6-7, two clubs out there. We have the opportunity for the high hand. Once again, quad sixes would be good, and it could potentially hold for $1,000. So here, very strong, and when action checks to me, I am actually going to go ahead and donk lead here. I like my donk lead because I think the preflop raiser could check a lot of the time, and obviously we're really not trying to let this check through since we are second last to act here, if that makes any sense. So I go ahead and throw out a pretty small bet of $20. Once again, the player to my left makes the call, the preflop raiser. Everyone else folds. So we're going to a turn, which is a seven. Really awesome card. We go ahead and boat up here, and knowing that he can call a lot of hands, if he's going to call on the flop, he's going to call on the turn, I think. So we bet $40, and he decides to make the call once again. Hopefully the flush can get there. The river is a five of hearts, so flush draw bricks out, and here in this spot I reach for chips, gotta bet for value obviously, and the moment that I reach for chips, on the corner of my out of the corner of my eye, I see him immediately reach for chips as well. So seems like a pretty strong indication that he's going to make the call. Originally going for a sizing of around $80, $75, pretty small to milk him in, but with that tell, knowing that he's probably going to make the call, let's size up just a little bit to $115. Without thinking too long, he sticks the chips in there. I show and win. He said that he had pocket tens, so he was calling down fairly light. So we take it down with our boat, and we got some more value there, all three streets of value, which is pretty nice. Next hand, we have pocket queens in the hijack. I raise things up to $15 over a limper. The player to my left, the small blind, the big blind, all make the call, so we're going to go to a flop. The flop comes jack 5-6, two hearts out there, and here just going to c-bet $40 when action checks to me. Only the small blind player makes the call. She's been playing pretty, I guess, decent, I'd say, mainly playing for value, so we know that she has a hand with at least some equity here, probably a jack. The turn, not a card we'd like to see. It is a jack, so her most likely holdings of jack high, top pair hands have now improved to trips. When she checks to me, here it's a pretty easy decision, just not comfortable betting here, and there's not really a whole lot of hands I'm targeting besides, I guess, straight draws and flush draws, so just going to check it back, and we go to a river, which is the three of hearts. She leads for $50, and this is just not a really great spot for us. We do have the overpair, but I mean, everything got there. Some straight, weird straight draws, like 7-4 got there. The obvious flush draw got there as well. And obviously, top pair on the flop has also improved. So really can't find a hand that we beat here in this spot besides some random hand like pocket 10s and 9s and stuff like that. So we just go ahead and let it go. Just know that she's always betting here for value, and just don't think I'm good here ever. I fold, and she showed ace, queen of hearts, so did have the nut flush draw and got there. Unfortunate for us, but finally made a good fold. Just a forewarning, the next two hands that we're going to go over are a little wild, so hope you're along for the ride. Here, pocket aces in the small blind, and the cutoff opens to $13. He's pretty active, and he's also pretty passive preflop usually. I haven't seen him make too many raises preflop, so here, aces, we're going to 3-bet. We 3-bet to $40, and he decides to make the call. So I know that he's near the top of his range, but not as top of his range as I am. So we're going to go to a flop three-way, heads up, actually, out of position. Flop comes, ace-king, three, two hearts out there. Once again, top set. What in the world is happening? We go ahead and lead out here for $75. It is a board that I obviously would always c-bet on, especially in a 3-bet pot, and this time I kind of have it. So definitely using my aggro image here to use, especially when I flop a flop like that. And he calls the $75, and we're going to go to a turn, which is the four of clubs. He has about $350 behind, and I want to commit his stack right here, right now, in case he's on a draw. In case he has some strong hand, maybe set over set, whatever it is, I just know that sometimes he can call on the lighter side, but here I know that he's at the top of his range as well. So we go ahead and throw out a bet of $200, going for the bigger side, like I said, trying to commit his stack. He thinks for a little bit and ends up making the jam, his whole stack for $350 total-ish. I go ahead, snap call, and we're going to a river. The river is the eight of diamonds, so hearts break out. We show, and we are good. We win a big one. He doesn't get a chance to show. He said that ace-king was good and just didn't really want him to show a hand that he didn't think was good. So top set, we're going to take it down. Last hand of the video, let's go over it. It is pocket kings on the button, another premium hand. We're sitting on a lot of chips after that last hand. And there's two limpers to a player on the hijack. He raises things up to $25. He's a pretty solid reg and watches the channel. He's been featured a couple times before, so shout out to you, John. Here with kings in position, let's 3-bet here to $80 total, and he decides to make the call. Knowing his play style, him knowing that he knows my play style, let's just see what happens here. The flop is pretty good for us. It's king 7-4, two diamonds. So once again, flopping top set. It seems to be the theme of today, just running really good. He checks to me, and once again, just going to continue firing. I bet $75, and he makes the call. The turn is the jack of hearts, essentially a brick. I mean, not really a brick, but I guess the flush draw misses, and we're still pretty confident with top set. And he thinks for a little bit and actually ends up ripping his whole stack in, total of about $350. I do not wait at all and throw in a chip there. So we snap call that with top set. We're off to a river card. The river is the six of hearts. He shows ace jack of diamonds, and we take that one down. Another really big stack coming our way. We were just on a heater today. It was absolutely insane, and we're off to the outro. All right, it's outro time, and so quick update. It's 2 a.m. right now. We got in a while ago. I think we started playing around 4 p.m. It's 2 a.m. Yeah, so I played for 10 and a half hours. It's been a wild day, and it was the session that we needed 3 months ago, or for 3 months, we needed it. Also, I've been up there for so long, I don't know where my car is, so I'm gonna wander, hope to find it, and talk along the way, so whatever. It's gonna be a journey to see where the hell I parked, because I don't really know. I hope I'm on the right floor at least this time, but yeah, this was the session we've been looking for forever because it was huge. We'll go over some numbers when I'm in the car, but I ran pretty good. Ran really good, obviously, to be up the amount that I am up. And it was all in 1-3. I can play 1-3 for 10 hours and I'm totally capable and confident in that. Run up the deep stack. I don't think I'm confident enough to play 2-5 for 10 hours and do that. Just don't have the experience or the bankroll to do that. But anyways, that was really good. And what more can I say? This is a good outro. I'm not pissed this time. For the first time in like 3 months, I played 1-3 and I am not pissed off. So what more can I say? This car parked like a real asshole. You're so close to me. I found my car. So that's good. Yeah, guys, if you follow me on Instagram, I was posting about my chip stack and what I had in my stack. Oh, craziness. We were just running pure. We were running really good, picking our spots. I thought I found some really good, made some really good folds, made some decent calls along the way, obviously, and I think I played above average. You know, like I said, I came into today feeling pretty stable and steady. We gotta turn off this radio. No, can't get that copyright strike. Anyways, at the end of the day, we were in the game for $600, out of the game for $2,420. So good profit of $1,800, which is just what I needed. It's literally just what I needed. So that's good. That's freaking good. Ran really well, got jammed into when I had top set twice, which is rare to find, and they're against pretty deep stacks. So really happy about that. Couple shout outs to make at the end of this video. If you're still watching, I don't know how, but shout out to Adrena, John, I always see you. Chad, it was nice meeting you. Brendan, Adam, I always see you. And everyone else that I met along the way today. Met so many of you guys, it's awesome. Jim, Bill, all of you guys. A lot of names that I'm also forgetting, I know, I'm sorry, but super cool to meet everyone that watches the vlogs and supports the channel. Anyways, this video has gone for a little too long now, so I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.